Blackstone Audio presents Dinner at Mr. Jefferson's, Three Men, Five Great Wines, and the Evening That Changed America, by Charles Cerami. Introduction. Just back from five idyllic years in France, eager for a quiet period at his Monticello home, Thomas Jefferson was jarred by the news that George Washington wanted him to be his Secretary of State. When he took a risk by accepting the post without being sure of Washington's political views, he soon found that it had been a mistake. On reaching the temporary capital, New York City, Jefferson was stunned to find that a majority of the state's people were probably already tired of democracy. The tone of their conversation sounded a distinct preference for the comfort of royal rule. And after he reported for work, he realized that Alexander Hamilton, whom he saw as a monarchist at heart, was on his way to becoming a one-man government, usually able to get his way with Washington and ready with a new plan for every conceivable need. We find these well-known people to be totally different from the way they are usually portrayed, behaving oddly, often close to desperation. Jefferson was a genius who could spread enchantment with words that had never been used quite that way before. But he and his close friend, James Madison, could not make Washington see why they suspected Hamilton of wanting to create a monarchy in America. And they feared that one of the younger man's proposals could put him in a position to accomplish just that. Blocking Hamilton, however, seemed as dangerous as letting him win, for the clash might wreck the young country's financial standing in the world, which Jefferson called the ultimate calamity. It would have stifled the nation's growth, mangled its future. Then Jefferson gave a dinner, one of many that were notable for their elegance, but this one was a history-making event, because it appeared that he was putting all the firepower into Hamilton's hands. Even the host thought he might have given too much. But the magic of Jefferson's touch and a dash of luck made it work out otherwise. This dinner-table compromise has been a plaything of historians ever since, with a variety of theories about what happened or whether it really happened at all. It did. And I hope you will find it, and all that flowed from it, coming alive in these pages. Chapter 1. Before the Clash. The Thomas Jefferson who arrived at Norfolk Harbor in late November 1789 was not the same man who had left for France almost 5 years earlier. He had acquired a French suavity and polish, a different cut of hair, and an elegance of clothing. In place of the loose, shambling gait of a Virginia farmer, he walked with the more measured steps of a continental gentleman and held his head with little or no movement. But he remembered his countrymen well. He knew that over 90% of them were farmers, and that this new version of himself would not do in America, not if he was to join the political world that President George Washington held out to him. He had not quite accepted, but he was already thinking of the style changes he would have to make. After all, his looks need not show in the letters he would write back to his French friends and near conquests. There, he could continue to show all the charm he thought they expected of him. He wanted to hold on to those 5 years, for they had been like a second youth. He had gone abroad as a middle-aged widower, still grieving for his lost wife, and also as a semi-retired politician who had to push himself to savor new experiences. But the magic of France had quickly enveloped him, making years that were his 40s seem like an enchanted span from, say, 25 to 30. At the time, it had not mattered so very much that his flirtations had been platonic, though it took an effort to keep from seeing this as a series of defeats. His justified confidence in his writing skills blinded him from realizing that his love letters were ponderous and even tiresome, possibly spoiling the opportunities that might have been. But nonetheless, there had been moments of titillation in the relationships, and his mind returned to these euphorically. Now, as he disembarked in Norfolk, he was startled to learn...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.